There's an old saying that the real test of a person's character is what they do when no one is watching. For quite a while, no one was watching three women who handled a lot of money for the city of Albuquerque. And then strange things started happening with that money. So officials decided to start watching them. And guess what they found? Here's News 13 investigative reporter Larry Barker.
Anytime we find fraud, waste, or abuse, it's a wake-up call.
As thieves, how good were they?
Not very. They got caught.
There isn't one of us who isn't enchanted with the adventures of notorious outlaws. Arabia had Ali Baba and his 40 thieves. Utah's Butch Cassidy had his hole-in-the-wall gang. And New Mexico has its very own Biopark gang. Doesn't ring a bell? Well, they weren't as clever as Butch, and they certainly did not evoke the romance of the Arabian Nights. Nevertheless, these modern-day desperados are noteworthy for a couple of reasons. First is how they pulled off their cunning caper. Second is how they got caught. You see, the gang's crime spree unraveled thanks to a high-tech gadget no bigger than a shirt button.
Nobody really knows how long they operated or how much money they got away with. What we do know, however, is that a trio of shady characters working for the city of Albuquerque based their illegal operation here at the city's biopark.
It's an Albuquerque showcase featuring sharks, sturgeons, sea turtles, stinging nettles, shipwrecks, swans, and stunning gardens. Last year, 1.2 million visitors passed through these gates, and every one of them stopped here first. And it's here at the ticket booth that visitors came face to face with Albuquerque's biopark gang. Last year, $4 million flowed through these cash registers. Most of it went into city coffers, and then some of it went into the pockets of the Biopark gang. But after a while, they got a little sloppy, and in December, the first clues surfaced. Something was amiss at the Biopark. John Soliday is Albuquerque's chief operations officer.
Director Betty Rivera over at Cultural Services was looking at reports that listed a combination of revenue and visitors at the biopark and noticed some anomalies.
The biopark caper was a dilemma for the city. Clearly, cash was disappearing, but no one could figure out who, what, where, when, and how. What do you do? Well, you go high tech. So city officials turned to the private investigation firm, RCI.
We went into the cashier's areas and installed hidden cameras like this pinhole camera over the cash register area.
It's a camera the size of a nickel. Cashiers did not know their every move was being recorded. For example, January 7th, 136. As this chatty Kathy is yakking away on her cell phone, she nonchalantly opens the register and helps herself to a couple of bills. Moments later, she pulls out her wallet and pockets the cash. 40 minutes later, she's at it again. She opens the register, steals a few greenbacks, and then hides it under the counter. At 2:46, her wallet comes out again, and moments later, she discreetly slips it into her jacket. Now, remember that money she stashed under the counter? Well, it's time to make it disappear into her jacket. And then there's the cashier we'll just call Sneaky. At 3:31, Sneaky hides behind a sheaf of papers, reaches into the register for some city money, and then slips it under the counter. Saturday, January 11th, 1105, the hidden camera catches a third clerk. We'll call her KG. She opens the register, counts out some bills. Not enough. Let's steal some more. She looks around, making sure no one's watching, and poof, the purloined cash disappears. Just before lunch, KG opens the drawer, pulls out a wad of cash, looks around, puts some money back, then leaves 20 bucks on the counter. Now you see it. Now you don't. At 2:18, KG snags a handful of cash, checks out the calculator, and like magic, the bills disappear. On the afternoon of Sunday, January 12th, Sneaky is up to her old tricks. She grabs a fistful of bills, wads up a few, glances around to make sure no one's looking, and then slips the stolen money under the counter. By mid-January, the hidden camera was pulled out and the undercover footage was reviewed by the private investigators.
The tedious part was having to view the videos very slowly to watch and catch these sleight of hand movements that would show us that the money wasn't getting into the cash register.
When confronted with the video evidence, all three cashiers confessed to embezzling city money. The investigation was then turned over to City Hall.
The staff we're talking about here, these cashiers are not really city employees. They're contracted to us through select staffing. Anybody in the city that handles cash actually has to go through a training program before they can do that. All of these cashiers went through that through our treasury department. And in addition to that, each of these cashiers, temporary employees, had two background checks. One through select staffing and one through the city. Nothing showed in any of those background checks.
No one is sure how long the cashiers had been stealing money.
How much money was stolen?
I don't have a good handle on that. I can't even give you a good estimate. It could be $1,000 or it could be much more. We simply don't know.
The BioPark gang was immediately fired, and this video evidence was turned over to the police department for a criminal investigation.
If you steal from us, we're going to fire you and prosecute. Pure and simple.
Larry Barker, KRQE News 13.
Because that criminal investigation is still going on, City Hall has not named the fired cashiers. Now, if you've missed any Larry Barker investigations or you just want to watch them again, head to KRQE.com and click on 13 Investigates.